gathering. It looks somewhat similar to the same protest that we saw 2 days ago, also in front of the French embassy in Tel Aviv. This one is actually larger and also involves some parliament members from the Joint Arab List, as well as various religious clerics. You can hear the chants right now that are being sung along with the Muslim symbols with those green flags. And with me here is actually one of the protesters, Muhammad. Muhammad, thanks for joining here. Tell me a bit about what's going on with this protest, because the concern from people viewing from the side is that we saw another terror attack this morning in Nice. That's a person beheaded, another school teacher who was beheaded 2 weeks ago. And it seems like the main anger is over the expressions or the speech of President Macron and others, while people seem to be remaining silent somewhat over the violence we've seen in the last 2 weeks.
No, actually, they are not silent about all these crimes that happens everywhere in the world, including also here or in France or everywhere in this world. We are against terror. We are against innocent killing everywhere in this earth. But we have to emphasize that what you are seeing here now is in order to express our anger and our frustration from the declaration of the President of Macron and his government and all this that claim that this is the free to speech. The free to speech is not about luxury to offend the beliefs and the prophets of the Islam.
In France, are you allowed to draw a cartoon, even if it's an offensive cartoon of a religion? Is that allowed under the law, or do you want to outlaw that?
Listen, we know that it could be allowed to criticize whatever you want. But I think that in 2018 in Vienna, the European Court has declared that offending the Prophet Muhammad is against the freedom of speech. It's not including in freedom of speech.
But in France, that is considered freedom of speech.
In France, it is not allowed even to criticize the policy of the Zionism of Israel. It is considered as offensive.
It is allowed. They criticize the Zionism all the time in France.
They are not allowed, because in France itself, with the government of Macron, they declare that criticizing the Zionism is and the policy of Israel, that we can discuss it.
You understand what
it is? Anti-Semitism. It is anti-Semitism. And if you criticize Islam, it is free to speech.
But you understand when they are saying here that in spirit and in blood we will avenge Muhammad, then people are concerned that maybe we will see another terror attack like we saw in Nice this morning.
I think the flame was brought by Macron himself. He was the encouraging of this crimes in France itself. If it was a crime, these guys who have done these crimes in France should be taken to the courts of France, but it does not mean that he has the right to offend and to offend religion.
But in democracy, don't you have the right to offend? In democracy, that's part of democracy. You have the right to say whatever you want.
We have the right.
And also, you have to be offended sometimes.
We have the right to speak whatever we know.
We are speaking, but we're talking about the people being beheaded in a church in France.
As soon as we respect all the prophets, because we believe that all prophets are brother between them, and all of us are humankind for one God, and we believe in what God, and therefore we were offended also if anybody everywhere in this world offend Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, or Mose, peace be upon him. We are against any offensive declarations against any faith or any religion in this world.
Okay, thank you very much, Muhammad. That was Muhammad here, one of the protesters at this very animated protest, as you can see, which is taking place today. And maybe we're going to see more of these protests in the next week, as we saw also in other places around the world. And this is going to be an ongoing saga, of course, that is taking place. Not